Fire at East Orrington. Painting by Waldo Pierce. Words by P.G. Hodgson. Jean McHale, Jennifer Hodgson. Waldo Pierce, David Troop.
Damn newspaper called me a boy because my name is Jean with a G. A small boy brought her the ring. If they'd been there in person instead of sitting in their office, they'd seen I was a girl. No boy ever wore a bathing suit like that.
I'm glad I painted the little crook sisters in. It's a nice touch, and I wish I could take credit for it, but they were actually there. They were running up from the stream about the same time I arrived, following the screams and the sirens. They were terrified the fire would spread to the house, though mostly over the family cat, which they couldn't find outside. They were convinced it was trapped somewhere upstairs.
I heard Mrs. Crook saying she lost her engagement ring. Then I saw it, laying in the grass, the red flames glinting off the diamond. I'd have missed it without there being a fire.
There was one fellow in full regalia running around with an axe, liable to kill someone with it.
That was Clyde. He was late to the fire. He was always late, because he always stayed to put on his uniform. Then, when he got there, everybody already had a job. So he just used to run around with his axe, shouting orders at people who were already doing things.
I didn't know his name, but he was more danger to himself than others. I nicknamed him Hemingway.
It must be awful having a fire. Having all your belongings thrown out of a window into the yard for everyone to see. Betty and Priscilla, my friends, the Crook girls, never did find their cat. They cried and cried. So did I.